Mr. Can you see the screen?
Yeah, yes. Yes, we can see the screen.
Okay, so let's start. ॐ वक्रतुण्ड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागस्त प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ धातु ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृति कृत सुबंतादिर धातु ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। सो वी हैव सीन द कर्तरी प्रयोग कर्मणि प्रयोग एंड द मीनिंग ऑफ द केसेस द मीनिंग ऑफ द सुबंत ऑल द केसेस यू हैव सीन तिंगंता लटलकारा नाउ Just let's look at, before moving on to Tattvabodha, I said we'll look at Tattvabodha, but since I was traveling, but now that I'm back and I couldn't conduct the classes there, let's look at the some more grammar before we go to the Tattvabodha. Subanta, let's look at the Rama Shabda. Declension we have seen, Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, Ramam, Ramo, Raman, Ramena, Ramabhyam, Ramaihi, Ramaya, Ramabhyam, Ramebhyaha, रामात् रामाभ्याम रामेभ्यः रामस्य रामयोः रामाणां रामे रामयोः रामेषु दीज आर दी 21 फॉर्म्स एंड देन देयर इज अ संबोधनम संबोधनम व्हिच इज अ प्रथमा संबोधनम व्हेन यू एड्रेस हे राम हे रामो हे रामः नाउ इट्स इजियर टू रिमेंबर दी फॉर्म्स इट्स इजियर टू रिमेंबर दी सुबंता फॉर्म्स देन लर्न थ्रू सूत्रास Here you see there's a lot of duplication. Ramo and Ramo, the first case and second case, as well as the Sambodhana, Ramo, Ramo, Ramo. So three forms are covered by knowing just one Ramo. Similarly, Ramebhya, Ramebhya. Most in all the whether it is a Strilinga, Pullinga, or neuter, in all of them the Ramabhyam, Ramabhyam, Ramabhyam. The Tritiya, Chaturthi and Panchami dual, the Dvivachana is same. Similarly, the Chaturthi Bahuvachana and Panchami Bahuvachana is same, Ramebhya, Ramebhya. So these are the forms that we get free. If you know one form Ramabhyam, you know that Chaturthi, Tritiya, Chaturthi, Panchami, Dvivachana, it has to be. And Ramebhya, if you see, you know that it is Chaturthi Bahuvachana or Panchami Bahuvachana. So you get both the forms knowing by one. Knowing one form. However, the difficulty is when you read the form, you have to make out the sense of the word, whether it is in Tritiya, Chaturthi or Panchami, when you see Ramabhyam, for example. But over a period of some time, this will be clear as to which meaning it is possible, which case it is possible, and maybe multiple also. Multiple possibilities all you know in the language. Similarly, another commonality is Ramayohu Ramayohu. The Shasti Divachana and Saptami Divachana, you get free. Once you know one form, you get both. So it's easier to know Subanta initially there is a difficulty in it seems to be a lot, but then you see similarities in the form across multiple words, then it becomes easier. So just read these whenever you get time, once or twice a day. Just go through the forms. Rama Shabda, Rama Shabda, Rama or Lata Shabda or Ganga Shabda, whichever you prefer. It's just three linga. Then you can go through Marut Shabda and Hari Shabda. Ramaha, Hari Shabda. In Pullinga, Rama Shabda, Hari Shabda and Marut Shabda. Marut is Vayu. And then in Strilinga, go through Rama Shabda, Lata Shabda or Ganga Shabda. You look at the forms. Try to recall the meaning. For Ramaha, Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha will be Karta in Kartari Prayoga or Karma in Karmani Prayoga. Then Ramam, Ramo, Raman would be Karma in Kartari Prayoga and second Karma in Karmani Prayoga. Then there may be other words that the avyayas which govern the second case. Therefore, Ramam can be a Karma for that avyaya. Like for example, Anu Ramam. Following Rama, Anu Ramam. Anu will govern second case, so you'll get Anu Ramam or Anu Ramau, Anu Raman, meaning something that follows Raman, multiple Ramas or Ramo, two Ramas or Ramam, Anu Ramam, following Ramam, following Rama. Ramena, Tritiya is, they say instrumental case, but here it is, Tritiya is either a Karana, Karane Tritiya, or it can be Karta in Karmani Prayoga. In Karmani Prayoga, Karta goes in third case. So, Ramena Ramabhyam Ramaihi Kriyate. Something is done by Rama, you say Ramena Kriyate. Or you say Ramaihi Kriyate. There may not be multiple Ramas here. It's a construct in Indian languages. Whenever you have respect the person, or you want to show your respect, you use Bahuvachana. So, Ramaihi Kriyate is not, Kriyate means Krudhatu, Kriyate is done. In Karmani Prayoga, passive voice is done. What is done? Something is done. That will be Karmani Prayoga. And if Vivaksha is not there, then you don't mention the Karma. But if Vivaksha is there, in Karmani Prayoga, that Karma will go in first case. So let's say, Ramena Setu Kriyate. The Setu, the Rama, the Setu is created, the bridge is created between India and Sri Lanka. Bridge is created, which is called a Setu. And Setu will go in first case in Karmani Prayoga. So Setu hu Kriyate. Setu is built. Bridge is built. By whom? Ramaihi. When you say Ramaihi, we are trying to say that Manarte Bahuvachana. With respect, for respect, you use Bahuvachana. Or Ramena Kriyate, singular also, because God is not different from you. You can very well use singular. Ramena Kriyate or Ramaihi Kriyate. Of course, Ramabhyam is not used because it is not Manartha. If there are two Ramas, you use Ramabhyam. Or if one is dropped, we'll see that in Panchavritti. Then Ramaya Ramabhyam Ramebhyaha. This is Sampradana, when something is given to Rama or for purpose of Rama. So Ramaya Karomi, I do it for Rama. I do Seva for Rama. So Ramaya Sevam Karomi. Karomi, I do. Aham Karomi, I do. What do? Seva. So, Seva is Karma for the Dhatu Kru in Karomi. And I say, Ramaya Sevam Karomi. Therefore, it goes in second case in Karma in Kartari Prayoga. Karomi is Kartari Prayoga. So, Ramaya Sevam Karomi. Then, Ramat Ramabhyam Ramebhyaha. Ramat Ramabhyam Ramebhyaha is Panchami, which is from Rama. So from Rama, from is a general translation. If you hold on to from as a general translation, you get most of the meanings. But if you learn through Sanskrit, there are multiple sutras which apply. So Ramat could be not from, but due to fear also. It can be Hetu Panchami. It can be because Bhaya governs Panchami. So whichever is the cause for fear, that will be in Panchami. So these kind of meanings apply. Ramat is from Rama. From Rama something has come also, that will be Rama. Ramat Panchami. Ramasya Ramayoho Ramanam. Ramasya Ramayoho Ramanam is Shashti. And Shashti is not a Karaka. You don't have Karaka in Shashti. Karaka, we have seen, Karaka has a Sambandha with the Dhatu. When the noun has a Sambandha with the Dhatu, we call it as a Karaka. All are Karakas except for Shashti. Shashti is a sambandha, and sambandha is possible only between nouns. It is not possible between a noun and a verb. I mentioned sambandha as a karaka. Karaka has a connection, but we don't have a good word. But karaka is, means that it, karaka means a noun is some way related, denotes, there's some kind of a connection between. So there is a connection between the dhatu, the kriya in the dhatu, kriya indicated by the dhatu of the verb and the noun, when there is a connection. Like Rama is a karta, Rama means a karma, Ramena means a is a karana, Ramaya sampradana. So all these are karakas. But Ramasya, Ramasya pita, Ramasya pita, if I say father of Rama, or Ramasya putraha, son of Rama, then it is connection between, it has nothing to do with the, say Ramasya putraha gachati, if I say putra has a connection with gachati, but Ramasya is, has no connection with gachati. Ramasya gachati has no meaning, but putraha gachati has a meaning, or pita gachati has a meaning. Whose pita? Ramasya. So that vivaksha is fulfilled by showing the connection between two nouns. That's why shashti is a sambandha, sambandha shashti, or sheshe shashti, when something is not being indicated or implied. I want to talk, I don't want to explicitly mention something as a karaka, then that also goes in sixth case. There are other technical cases when sixth case is mandatory. When there is a kridanta pada, kridanta is basically, kridanta means a noun, a pratipadika, which is derived from a dhatu using a pratyaya called a kridanta pratyaya. So that kridanta word, when a particular set of kridanta words are used and its karta or karma is there, then that karta or karma of the kridanta should go in shashti. There are some rules, and that is also another case of shashti. Ramasya ramayo ramana. So shashti is wide open. It is if we do not know which case to put in, if we are confused, we can very well get away by putting it in sixth case. And that is how we have to read as well. If we do not understand what is the meaning here, sheshe shashti, we say it is used. It can be in the sense of fourth case, it can be in the sense of seventh case, or in second case. Such possibilities do exist. When you see a shashti in a first you read that, it may be a sambandha shashti. If it is not a sambandha shashti, then it can be some other type of shashti. We have to understand that. If we can't find a noun which connects to the shashti, when we analyze a sentence. Saptami. Saptami is adhikarane. Adhikarana is the locus of the action. So, Rame, Ramayoho, Rameshu. Rame bhakti asti. So, it can also be said, towards Rama, I have bhakti. Ramasya prati. Rame equal to Ramasya prati. Towards Rama, I have bhakti. Rame bhakti asti. Or, adhikarana. So, instead of Rame, you say, ghatatale. Bhutale ghata asti. So, on the floor, on the surface of the floor, there is a pot. So that will also be as adhikarana saptami. Rame ramayoho rameshu in plural. And he Rama, when you address he Rama, this is the only place where the visarga lopa is there. You see, the visarga lopa means elision of the visarga when you address he Rama. But second case and third case are same. He Ramo, he Ramaha. This is a recap of Rama Shabda. And similarly, let's look at the other Shabdas. And once you get, I had mentioned 60% of the language is covered once you know Rama Shabda. You open any book and find out more than 60%. 60% was a vague figure, I remember. Maybe the figure was 80%. I forgot to cross check. 80% of the language may get covered once you know Rama Shabda. So it is important to learn this by rote. Even if you don't have to, you know, spend a lot of time, you just look it up once a day. Over a period of time, you'll get it. See, these are the other words which we keep on regularly coming across. So, Acharya, Deva, Bhoga, Ishwara, Devadatta, Loka, Guna, Desha, Vishaya, Grama, Village, Deha, Vruksha, Ghata, Putra, Veda, Chandra, Purusha, Shishya, Jana, Sambandha, Prana, Jeeva, Brahmana, Surya, Tyaga, Bhedhasta. And if you, most of you look at your names, they will mostly be Akaranta. Most of them, I mean, masculine. In feminine, you will have Akaranta or Ekaranta. So once you learn Akaranta or Ikaranta also, lot of it is covered. Hari Shabda also in masculine, it will cover Ikaranta. So let's skip this and go to Rama Shabda. Let's look at another thing before going into Rama Shabda, let's look at some pronouns also. Now there is a Sarva is a pronoun. Sarva, this pronoun will see sarva is also akaranta. Like akaranta pullinga Rama shabda, you will have sarva shabda. Sarva means everything, all. So pronoun, how does it decline? You look at it, Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha. You have Sarvaha, Sarvo, Sarvaha it should have been. But there is only one difference. Instead of Sarvaha, you get Sarve. So if you know Rama Shabda, and just by these bold letters marked in bold, which have not faded, you get mileage of pronouns also. So Sarve, Sarvasmai. Instead of Ramaya, you get Sarvasmai, not Sarvasya, how do you say it, Sarvasaya. You don't get Sarvaya, sorry. No, you don't get Sarvaya, you get Sarvasmai. But other cases are, all of these other forms are same as Rama Shabda. So you know the Rama Shabda, then look at the differences. 1, 3, 4, 1, Panchami. Panchami Sarvasmat is a difference, because otherwise you should have got Sarvat, like Ramat. But here you get Sarvasmat. What is the difference here? You see, instead of, there's a sma. Sma comes and sits in between. Instead of sarvat, you get sarvasma. The sma is an addition. Even here, sarvasmai. You see, smai is an addition. Instead of sarvaya, you get smai. So there is a replacement here. Similarly, ramanam. Instead of ramanam, you get sarvesham. That's another difference. And saptami, instead of rame, you get sarvasmin. So you get sarvasmin, anyasmin, anya shabda will also be covered. If you know sarva shabda, sarvasmin, anyasmin, anya is different, someone else, other. Other is also pronoun is covered. Sarva means everything or all, that is covered. If you know rama shabda and you know some differences, even if initially you make mistakes, sarvasmi, you try sarvaya, still it's not an issue. Over a period of time you will get the difference. But once you see sarvasmai in the form, when you read, then you will get that this is sarvasmai. What is the sarvasmai? Over a period of time, you will get that this is chaturthi. Sarvasmat, anyway, at is a giveaway. You will see at, like ramat, you will either, the error you may end up making is sarvasma. But sarvasma is something that in local languages also, regional languages, you don't have sarvasma. You have sarva. So you will end up guessing that it is a sarva shabda. So you will not make a mistake in error in guessing the meaning. You land on the meaning one way or the other. So use shortcuts wherever possible, since you do not want to study Sanskrit deep. If you want to study Sanskrit deep, then spend some time. Otherwise, to understand the say Tattva Bodha, etc., you can start off by using shortcuts initially. Sarvasmi, Sarvasmat is Panchami, like Ramat. So Sarva is the word you can guess. Sarvasma. And sarvasmaya does not exist, therefore sarva is the word. You can land on the meaning. Sarvesham. Sarvesham, again sarvesham. Sha. This sha is an addition instead of na. So instead of ramanam, you get esham. You get esham. You have sarvesham as the form. So for all of these. Now see, sarve, sarva, sarvasya will also mean for all. Or for everyone. You can say sarvasya is for everyone, but sarvesham for all. So sarva can be translated as each and everyone, or all. These translations are possible, but sarva is not necessarily plural. It declines in singular and dual also, because there may be multiple groups of sarva. So you can have two groups, sarva yoho, if you say, then shashti for both groups, including everyone in each group. So sarvayo has that kind of usage. Sarvasmin, sarvayoho, sarveshu. In this sarvasmin, instead of sarve, rame, you get sarvasmin, because sarve is used in 1-3. You see, in prathama bahuvachan, sarve is used. So it is not sarvaha like ramaha, it is sarve. And in rame saptami, it is sarvasmin. So one may get confused with sarve as saptami ekavachana initially, but it is not saptami ekavachana, it is prathama bahuvachana. So you get, by knowing a few differences, you get a pronoun also by Rama Shabda. And similarly, other pronouns will decline, like anya. Anya means another or other. Ubha, ubha means both. So ubhayoho, you may read a lot of ubhayoho for both. Shashti dvivachana, ubhayoho, or ubhe. Ubhe tirtva. So ubhe will be seen in. So if you know Rama Shabda and you know few forms, few differences, then you will get Anya Shabda, Ubha Shabda, Sarva Shabda, Purva Shabda. Purva is before or east. Anyatara. Anyatara is one among the two. One among the two. Ekaha, Ekasmin. So Ekasmin, you see the form Ekasmin. You don't see AK. You see Ekasmin instead of AK. AK you will see, but AK will be Prathama Bahuvachana. Vishwa. Now Vishwa, Vishwa means all. Vishwa can also mean, has a different meaning also, as in the world. But that will be a neuter. Vishwam you will get. Vishwam, when it declines like a neuter, the meaning is the world. But Vishwa, when it declines like a pronoun, then it means all. Like Sarva. Sarva equal to Vishwa. Itara. Itara, Anya, Itara have the same meaning. Anya, other. Itara also other. Para. Like Purva. Purva can mean before or east. Para can mean after or another. It has multiple meanings. Para. Swa. Swa is, so you have see swasmin. You don't get sway. You get swasmin, meaning in oneself. You will see a lot of times in Vedanta, you see swasmin. Swasmin tishtati. A person remains in oneself is called swasmin tishtati. That person remains in oneself. Swa. Swa is also a pronoun to mean oneself. Or it is used as a reflexive pronoun for Atma. Swasmin. So you say it is a reflexive for oneself. In oneself. Swasmin. So this is the advantage of learning Rama Shabda. You get a lot of mileage, and just by five additional differences, you get Sarva Shabda also. And this has to be used for Rama Shabda also. Once you know Rama Shabda, you get Sarva Shabda by knowing a few differences between Rama and Sarva Shabda, which is a Strilinga, Sarva in Strilinga. There are other pronouns like Tad, Yad, Etad, Kim. Tad means something that is at a distance, that. Which means that. Yad Shabda is which. That which. So you say that which. Tad Yad. Yad and Tad will be seen as relative and correlative in a sentence. So say Yad Vadati Tad Karomi. So that which someone tells me, I do. So Tad Karomi. So Yad and Tad will go as relative, correlative. And it will decline. It's a pronoun in Pullinga. It can be in other genders also. Etad. Etad is this. So if you know Tat Shabda, if you learn Tat Shabda, then you just add A before Tat Shabda, you will get Etad Shabda. So you don't have to learn Etad Shabda separately. And Kim Shabda. Kim Shabda also declines in three genders. These are important to know because these keep on occurring throughout the language. So just let's look at one, the Tat Shabda. Tat Shabda meaning that in neuter, but in masculine and feminine also you can say that person. That person, whether it is masculine, then it will be he. And if it is in feminine, it will be she. Similarly here, Tat Shabda declines in, you look at declension in masculine. What is the difference once you know Rama Shabda, Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha. But in if you know Sarva Shabda, this Sarva Shabda that we just saw, which is what? Sarvaha, Sarvau, Sarve, not Sarvaha. If you know Sarva Shabda, then you just, for Tat Shabda, all you have to do is replace that by Tau. So, Ta. So here, this Tat Shabda, you see the similarity. Sarvaha, Sarvau, Sarve. Similarly, forget sa right now. Sa is the only difference. Only one form you have to change. You don't get taha. You get, instead of tat shabdas taha, you get saha. And that you remove the dakara. Ending tad dakara if you remove, you get ta. Instead of taha, you get saha. This is the only difference between sarva shabda and tat shabda. So sarva, sarvau, sarve. You get saha, tau, te. Then sarvam sarvau sarvan, you get tam tau tan. Everything else is same. Tena tabhyam taihi tasmai. Sarvasmai we had seen, you get tasmai tabhyam tebhya tasmat sarvasmat. Instead of ramat, you got sarvasmat. The sma came and sat in between. For tad also, dakara is, you remove dakara and say tasmat. Tasmat tabhyam tebhya tasya tayoho tesham tasmin tayoho teshu. Like sarvasmin, you get tasmin. And this is how you learn incrementally. You know one word, you look at the differences between Ramaha and Sarva Shabda, then Sarva and Tat Shabdaha, only one difference. You see Saha, only Prathama Ekvachana, if you make out the difference, then everything else you will have got by just knowing Sarva Shabda, which is knowing five forms different from Rama Shabda. So Rama Shabda itself has brought us so far. And if you continue in this way, this is how you cover the entire language. So yaha pashyati saha janati yaha. So yad shabda is also covered by tat shabda. Instead of saha, you get yaha. Here, by yad shabda. Now, how do I know yad shabda? Yad shabda is which. So relative. Saha taute, instead of that, I'll get yaha yau ye. Yam yau yan. Yena yabhyam yaihi. Yasmai yabhyam yebhya. And slowly you try to recollect the meaning, in which case which meaning follows. This is how you get additional mileage. With each increment you get a lot. Similarly, yasmat purchasi tasmat vadami. Yasmat is because. It is a hetau panchami. Since you ask, yasmat, because you ask, tasmat, therefore I utter, or therefore I reply. So there is no difference between tat shabda and yat shabda, only saha and yaha you have to make out the difference. That's the only difference. And once you know saha shabda, you know esha also. Etat, tat shabda, etat shabda. Only a you have to add, and instead of saha you get eshaha. Esaha, and esaha will become eshaha. Murdhanya, you will have eshaha. But everything else is same. Instead of tau, you get etau. Instead of te, you get ete. Instead of etayo, tayoho, you get etayoho. Instead of tesham, you get etesham. Instead of etasmai, you get etasmai. And etasmai will mean for this. For this. Etat shabda means this. And tat shabda means that. For this. Yasmai will mean for which. So, that is the etat shabda. How about kim shabda? Kim shabda also same as all this tad, etad, and kim shabda, they will decline very similar. Kaha kau ke, instead of saha tau te, you get kaha kau ke. Instead of yaha yau ye, you get kaha kau ke. This will means kaha means who. Who in masculine? Who is he? So kaha saha, who is he? Or kau, when say saha tau te, kau tau, who are they? So this is how the conversation can be once you know kaha shabda, just like sarva shabda, which is little different from rama shabda. See, by knowing just one tinganta and knowing akaranta shabda, you can make a sentence like this. You can understand this sentence. Ye ke janaha etam shlokam patanti Ishvara tan rakshati. What is the meaning? Rakshati. Rakshati is kartari prayoga. This means protects. Rakshis to rakshane. We know in local language also, we know rakshana. In any of the regional language, rakshana is to protect. So rakshati protects. Who protects? You have to look for karta in first case. What is the first case here? Ishvara. So Ishvara rakshati is the basic sentence. Ishvara protects. Whom does Ishvara protect now? So tan rakshati. He protects them. Tan is like Raman. It is Dvitiya Bahuvachana. It is a karma for Rakshdhatu. So Tan Rakshati. Ishvara protects them. Now when you say them, them is a pronoun. Who are they? So you have to go back and look for a relative. Relative. So Tat Shabda, correlative. You have to look for a relative which is Yad Shabda. And Yad Shabda need not be Yan. It can be in any case. It can be in any case, it can be in any number. So here you have to look for, here you see ye. So ye you see here, so ye something, ye patanti. So here you see another word, ye patanti tan rakshati. Those who, ye is plural, ye ke, who. So ye ke will give the sense whosoever. Whosoever read, whosoever janaha, whichever people, so whoever as a, janaha is also plural. So, yeke janaha. Whichever people etam, this shlokam patanti. Patanti. So, yeke patanti is kartari prayoga. Whoever reads or studies. Studies what? Shlokam. Because shlokam is a karma for pat. It is in second case. So whichever, not person, but whosoever, whichever people, it's difficult to translate yeke janaha in English. You say whichever set of people or whichever groups of people study shlokam, study this verse, this etam, this verse, whichever verse is being indicated, this verse they study, Ishwara tan rakshati, Ishwara protects them. Because the shloka itself has that kind of power, Ishwara will protect them. This is how, if you know one Rama Shabda and a little difference like for pronoun, you understand the sentence, Ye ke janaha etam shlokam patanti, Ishwara tan rakshati. That's the benefit of Akaranta Shabda, Pullinga Shabda. Now, Napunsakal Linga, neuter, how do you make out the neuter Shabda Akaranta? So, you know, Rama Shabda, Ramaha Ramo Rame, Ramaha Ramo Ramaha, Ramam Ramo Raman, Ramena Ramabhyam Ramaihi. The only difference is in Prathama and Dvitiya, and Prathama means Sambodhana Prathama also. Instead of Ramaha, the neuter will be Jnanam. You will not have Jnanaha. Neuter will be Jnanam. And instead of Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, you get Jnanam, Jnane, Jnanani. And second line is same as first line. Jnanam, Jnane, Jnanani, Jnanam, Jnane, Jnanani. Or Phala. Phala, you say Phalam, Phale, Phalani, Phalam, Phale, Phalani. Everything else is same as Rama Shabda. Except for, of course, Sambodhana, because He Rama, He Rame, He Ramaha, He Ramo, He Ramaha, you would have got. But this will be same as Prathama. And Prathama is Jnanam, Jnane, Jnanani. Therefore, you will get Sambodhanam, He Jnana, Makara Lopa will happen like Vasarga Lopa, He Ramaha had become He Rama. Similarly, He Jnana, Jnanam will be He Jnana, He Phala, He Jnane, He Jnanani. Everything else is same, Jnanena, like Ramena, you get Jnanena. The only difference is that Nakara and Nakara difference is there, but that is trivial. It's a pronunciation difference, and we'll know when to say na and when to say na, whichever is simpler you say that, otherwise the tongue will twist. You can't say Rame na, it is difficult, Rame na it will be. There is a rule when preceded by Repha, whenever Murdhanya or Repha precedes and followed by Ikara, such rules are there that Nakara will become Nakara. There is a Murdhanya Adesha. But otherwise, Jnane na, everything else is same. Jnane na, Rame na, you see the similarity in forms. Jnanena Jnanabhyam, Ramena Ramabhyam Ramaihi. So just by knowing the first two lines, you get the entire neuter. Akaranta neuter, you get completely. And by that, other words like Anna, Annam, Chaitanyam, Patram, Vairagyam, Aranyam, Jalam, Pustakam, Shariram, Indriyam, Tattvam, Prakaranam, Shastram, Kamalam, Dukkham, Phalam, Shilam, Karanam, Dhanam, Mitram, Sadhanam, Karanam, Nagaram, Vanam, Sukham, Karyam, Netram, Vastram, Hridayam, Kshetram, Patram and Vakyam are decline similar, same as Phala Shabda or Jnana Shabda. Now, Napunsakalinga pronoun, how will it decline? Same as Phala Shabda, there is no difference, or Jnana Shabda. Jnanam Jnane Jnanani Sarvam Sarve Sarvani Sarvam Sarve Sarvani Sarvena Sarvabhyam Sarvaihi Sarvasmai Sarvabhyam Sarvebhyah Sarvasmat Sarvabhyam Sarvebhyah Sarvasya Sarvayoho Sarvesham Sarvasmin Sarvayoho Sarveshu He Sarva He Sarva Sarve He Sarvani. So there is no difference between, once you know neuter, there is no difference between the Jnana Shabda or Sarva Shabda that you have learned, in that the first two lines will be same as Jnana Shabda and everything else is same as what you have already studied, Sarvasma, Sarvasmai. In Phala you will not get Phalasmai, you will get Phalaya, it will be same as masculine. So neuter will decline similar to masculine except for the first two lines. Similarly, Sarva Shabda in neuter will decline like Sarva Shabda in masculine. Not like Jnana Shabda, but like Sarva Shabda in masculine. But the first two lines will be same as the neuter Phala Shabda or Jnana Shabda. First two lines of the neuter Sarva Shabda. This we have already seen, what is Sarva Shabda. Now let's look at, so Yattat. Yattat also, Yattat, yat tat etad and kim shabda in neuter. How will it decline? Tatte tani tatte tani. So like jnanam jnane jnanani, you get tatte tani. Only tad and the first two cases you have to know. Like saha you had known in masculine, you say saha, saha tau te. Saha is to be known as different from the Rama Shabda, Sarva Shabda. There, Saha, Tat, it will not be Taha, it will be Saha. Similarly here, it will be Tat. Tat, this is the only difference. You know Tat, everything else is same. Tatte Tani, like Phalam Phale Phalani or Jnanam Jnane Jnanani, you will not get Tadam. Like Jnanam, you will not get Tadam, but you will get Tat. It will remain Tat. This is the only difference. Everything else is same as the masculine Tat Shabda. Yat also same. You have to know instead of tat, tat you know yat and etat. Everything else is same. Kim. Kim instead of kaha, you get kim. Kim remains kim in neuter. It does not become kaha. In strilinga, it will become ka. This is the only difference. Kim. It will remain kim. So kim karoti. You ask kim karoti. So kim is neuter. And when you don't know the gender of anything, then you use neuter. Samanye. Napunsakalinga. So samani, when in general you use napunsakalinga when you do not know the gender. If you know the gender, you have to specifically use don't know the gender in the sense it does not mean that you don't know the word whether it is in which gender it is. It means in a situation you do not know, like for example somebody knocks at the door, you don't know whether it is a man or a woman without looking through the window or the keyhole, then that time you're supposed to use kim neuter, supposed to use kim. This is how this is what I meant by saying that if you do not know the gender of the in a situation, if you do not do, but the word has to go with the gender that it is there in grammar. Hari shabda, let's look at ikaranta shabda now. Pullinga harihi hari harayaha harim hari hari harin. Now you see Hari is a short vowel. E is a, it is ending in a short ikara. Harihi, Hari, but in dual it will become jirga. So we have to look at which places it becomes jirga, and then the pronunciation becomes simple, and to remember also it becomes simple. In 2-2 and 1-2, 1-2-2-2, it will become jirga. In 2-3 also it will become jirga. In 6-3 it will become dhirga. These are the only places where it will be dhirga. Of course, sambodhana. Sambodhana is prathama, so I'll not mention that. But in shashti bahuvachana, in dvitiya bahuvachana, and in prathama and dvitiya dvivachana, there's a dhirgatvam of ikara. So harihi, hari, harayaha, harim, hari, harin, harina, haribhyam, harivihi, haraye, हरिभ्याम हरिभ्यः हरेः हरिभ्याम हरिभ्यः हरेः हर्योः हरीणाम हरौ हर्योः हरिषु हे हरे हे हरि हे हरय. Now we have already seen that 1-2 and 2-2 have same forms. 3-2, 4-2 and 5-2 have same forms. Then 4-2 and 4-3 and 5-3 have same forms. But additionally, Hari Shabda in Panchami Ekavachana and Shashti Ekavachana also you have same form. Like in Rama Shabda, you would have got Ramat and Ramasya here. Here the forms are different. But here Harehe Harehe. In everything, in Marut Shabda also, in Halanta Shabda, in Strilinga also, Panchami Ekavachana and Shashti Ekavachana also are same forms. So this is another mileage you get. You don't have to remember a lot. Haryoho Haryoho in 6-2 and 7-2 also same forms. So Hari Shabda also please look up. It is easier. If you read Rama Shabda, Hari Shabda, Marut Shabda, Rama Shabda once a day, just four, it will take barely 3 minutes. Just read them 3 minutes per day and across a week you will see how much you know. This is for of course those who do not know. Those who already know don't need to do that. So Agni, so by Hari Shabda you will get a lot of other Shabda like Agni. Agni is also a very common word. Upadhi. Upadhi in Vedanta is very important. In Nyaya Shastra also Upadhi is very important. Granthi in Vedanta. Vanni is same as Agni, fire. Atithi. Atithi in Dharma Shastra you will see a lot of Atithi. Rishi is all over the place. Nrupati is rare, but then you'll see it in Kavya as king. Vyadhi, disease. In Dharma Shastra, you'll see the word Vyadhi. Ari, Ari is the enemy. Kapi, monkey. Pani, Pani. Pani is commonly seen in Stotras and things like that. So Pani, Pani Bhyam. Pani is the hand. Interestingly, the word marriage is Pani, Pani Grahanam, holding the hand. This is a marriage ceremony. Pani Grahanam. Vidhi. Vidhi is an injunction. This is a very common word in Dharma Shastra as well as in Vedanta. Asi. Asi is a sword. You will see this in Mundaka Upanishad, for example. Kavi. Kavi, Mani, Ravi, Adi. Adi is very common. Adi is beginning, but we will translate it as etc. Because most of this Adi as an individual, single, as a word, independent word, we will translate as beginning. But Adi in conjunction, in a compound, let's say, say Ganapati Adi. Ganapati Adi will say starting with Ganapati or Brahmadi. Brahmadi Stambha Paryantam. So Brahmadi is starting with Brahma, but we'll also say Brahma, etc. But technically the meaning is starting with Brahma, beginning with Brahma. Ganapati, Munihi, Sarathi, Udadhi. Udadhi is an ocean. Girihi, mountain. Yatihi, sannyasi. So all these are words which you get by knowing one Hari Shabda. Therefore Hari Shabda is also important. We'll stop here. We'll look at Srilinga Shabda next time, and then we'll look at Panchavritti, various ways in these nouns make combinations, or various ways in nouns are formed by Dhatu or through another noun, by compounding nouns, by compounding nouns and dropping one noun. All of this we'll see, a little overview of that, and then we'll get into. So maybe in a couple of classes we'll get into Tattva Bodha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.